everyone, and welcome. This is Mark from the Glomex SRE squad. Today we do a screencast on AWS Serverless Scaffolding using GCDT. AWS Serverless consists of two services, AWS Lambda and API Gateway. These two services are a modern approach to creating cost-efficient RESTful service APIs. We will cover today coding a simple AWS Lambda function, testing the code, scaffolding config files, and deploying the service to AWS. The scaffolding I'm about to show to you is a new GCDT functionality which is not released yet. We need to complete the review, but are confident that we can release the scaffolding with the upcoming GCDT release. I understand that not every one of you is used to write code on a day-to-day basis, so I try to keep it simple. The code I am going to write implements a simple add function, just like the one you have on your mobile phone calculator. It is okay if you do not fully understand all the things that are going on in the background and are provided by AWS services. Do not get alarmed. What I want to highlight today is how easy it is to use AWS Serverless in an automated and repeatable fashion. So please focus on the aspects on how we implement a new service as infrastructure as code. Our goal is to make it easy and efficient as possible to get started with Serverless REST APIs. Our focus with GCDT scaffolding is to get developers started with useful structure and configuration. You adjust the configuration later in case your service needs fine-tuning. In this way, you focus on implementing business logic of your application. You commit the service infrastructure configuration to GitHub alongside your code, so you can review changes, plus you are able to always recreate your service infrastructure for your service. I'm going to start by writing the code which is at the heart of our service implementation. Like I said, I'm going to demonstrate an add function which simply adds two integer values and returns the result. I created a folder to hold the files for our service. So let's get started. So this is the signature of our add function. And we get a result, which is the sum of x and y. So what I'm also going to add is an Easter egg. For the purpose of this demo, the Easter egg represents something we do not want in the code, like for example, a bug. So our Easter egg is writing automated tests is very important, so I want to show this to you. The other day, somebody was complaining to me that testing Lambda function code is hard. That, I think, is not true. Hopefully, I can manage to convince you that testing Lambda function, in fact, is easy. So to get started, we already have the implementation for a function, and now we add a new file for the test. So we import and we need PyTest for that. So we going to add a file to do the installation for PyTest. And now we are going to add a simple test. So this is a JSON structure. So we get out the result, and we assert that it is our expected value. So we run the test. And the test works, passes screen, everybody's happy. Now let's add another test. So we want to do more testing. So we do another test. And so we use, for example, 17 and 25. So our result should be like 42. So now we have two tests and we run the test. Two tests passed. Great. But actually, this is not so great. So we should find the Easter egg, and so the test should be red and highlight the Easter egg. So the problem with that is that the tests are weak, and I want to show you how to write more powerful tests. So let's change the implementation of our test. So get rid of this one, and we do parameters here. So we're more flexible, and we verify that we have so we parameterized our test, and now we need data for our test. So this is a data-driven test. So let's say our function is allowed to have two-digit values. If I can type. So this function just iterates through x and iterates through y, and then yields the result. So we can use it in the test. And so we tell it to parameterize. So that's basically it. We parameterize the test with our add data. So, and now we run the test. So it has to run all the like 10,000 tests, and it already shown us that we have a problem in our implementation, and it's so it highlights. It says okay, we have. With x4 and y4, we have this problem, and we go back into the application and fix the problem here. Run the test again. And all 10,000 tests passed green. Everybody happy now. Now we change gears and prepare our app for rollout to our AWS account. We add a dependency. And use it in our application. set the application name and use it to set define the route for our function. With the route config, we can now prepare all the necessary wiring for deployment. We use the GCDT scaffolding for that. So we go through a dialogue where we get asked a question regarding our service. And I use the scaffolding before, so GCDT remembers my last entered values. And since I'm going to use this account often, so this is helpful for me. So I'm still using the infra account for deployment. So here it asks me which environments I want to deploy to, and I use dev, and just for kicks, I use another environment. So we have one service, and we scaffold the configuration for two environments. It asks also for the AWS region. We use Ireland for that, and we have a timeout. This is defaults to 5 minutes, and we define the memory for our Lambda function to 128 megabytes. And now you see it created files for me. This is the configuration for the dev environment. So it sets the region. And it has also the name in for this environment set up. Same for the production configuration. And it also provided the API, open API specification, the Swagger file that we need for deployment. So with that, we can go to the next step and deploy the function to our AWS account. So no magic here. So I set up the environment to dev, and account to infra. So this is my standard configuration for my terminal. If I do something else, I have to change it. And so we deploy in two. So next we deploy our app using two AWS services, Lambda and API Gateway. We wanted to keep the fine-grained control, so we deployed these two separately. So I already opened the console here, so that we can check that the deployment was actually made, and I don't play any tricks on you. So in my console, I have a configuration. I just want to show you quickly. So I set the environment to dev. And the account to infra. This is my standard configuration for the console. So I have to change it if I do something else. But this is the configuration we use in this screencast. So I use our GCDT tool Ramuda to deploy the service to AWS. So this takes a moment, and if it's done, we go to the AWS web console to see. So it was all fine, and this is for the simple example. We don't need the ping. And so now I go to Lambda functions and I see the mass service deployed. So this is only half of our deployment. So next we deploy the API gateway. So this is the command to do the API gateway deployment. So this goes quicker, since it's just wiring in the API gateway. And when we go to the console for API gateway, we now see the API gateway deployed to our dev stage. We can also use the service to try it out. So this is live now. Another value. So you see it's really doing what it's supposed to do. So that's it. Next step, we don't want to keep that forever, so we have to clean up and remove the sample code. So we just use the GCDT tool to remove the code. So we go for Eugen. So to reload quickly, and now it's gone. And also for the Lambda, so and here we also have to give the name of the service. So just to make sure that nobody is accidentally removing anything from his account. And quickly reload, now it's gone. Wrapping up, I just showed you how to code a simple AWS Lambda function, how to test the code, how to do scaffolding for the config files, and how to deploy the service to AWS using GCDT. The SRE squad hopes that these improvements make your work with GCDT and AWS serverless services much easier. We are committed to further work on usability improvements in the upcoming weeks. If you'd like to try it out and use GCDT scaffolding for your squad, come see us. So again, if you find this video helpful, please share it with your coworkers. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one. Keep in touch. Bye.